HITPmusic.com, boy.
What's good, Lindsey Gamble here, HITPmusic.com, hard in the paint. We're at Mass Apparel as always, and I'm here with Wizz Dakota.
What up?
What's poppin'?
Good, man.
Man, it's good to meet you.
Fine, man.
I know, it's been, I've been following your music for maybe like a year and a half or so. And ever since then, man, I've really been in tune with everything you're dropping. Before we get into actual music, just, you know, tell everyone where you're actually from.
I'm from Methuen, Massachusetts.
Where?
30 minutes away from Boston.
Yeah, so like, I mean, most, you know, everyone, the whole like Massachusetts scene is kind of centered around Boston hip hop, but of course it includes guys like yourself. But you being, you know, 30 minutes outside of Boston or whatever, how do you really feel like, how do you fit into the, you know, the city or the whole state's kind of hip-hop scene?
I don't know, I guess I just, with the music, it travels everywhere, so it don't really matter where you're at.
Yeah.
Cause like the music talks for itself, it was, like, I don't know how to explain it, but like, I don't do the same music I do, that like, they do in my city. Like, I relate more to the people over here, I guess.
Right. I mean, like you said, music does travel because, I mean, you know, SoundCloud's been like your big platform. It's been like a lot of people's big platform. For the last, maybe the last few months, really utilized SoundCloud. Been doing this Wizz Wednesday series. Just kind of talk about what made you think about doing that.
Well, my name's Wizz.
Yep.
Wednesday is like, I don't know, I always loved Wednesdays. I don't know why, because like...
Hump Day.
I don't know. I don't know, and then I want Wednesdays just to be about me, like, you know, everybody's always turn up Friday and Saturday and Sunday. But I want, like, Wednesdays to be, like, yo, let me listen to some Wizz Dakota on a Wednesday. Yeah. Like, so far it's been working out, like, I get, like, Snapchats. Girls getting ready on Wednesdays, like for the day.
Yeah.
They bump in my music. That's what I want. I like when you see Wednesdays, you be like, oh shit, this is a Wizz Dakota.
Nah, that's dope. That makes sense. I definitely seen, like, you know, just watching the, you know, your retweets and social media. People do fuck with the whole Wednesday thing. And it's kind of like, you know, McConan. At one point, Tuesdays kind of belong to McConan. But yeah, I mean, definitely now, like, whenever I think of Wednesday, especially because you put out the project.
Yeah.
So Wizz Wednesdays, like, you know, you did that for a couple of months, and then that led to the project called Wednesday.
The project is like, I did it because those are all my Wizz Wednesday releases, but I wanted to hear the songs like in a certain order.
Yeah.
So I just put it together like that. I put like my favorites in a little playlist, and then like I put it in an order. That's why I made that little project.
Word, because I mean, since I came across the music, my thing was always, or just coming across anyone's music, you know, you can make singles, you can make, you know, bangers, anthems, whatever. And those songs can stand on their own, but how do they stand together as a body of music? And I think even, I'm not sure if you really went into it as this being a project, like full rollout the way you released the music, but, you know, when I listen to it front to back, it sounds, you know, pretty concise. You have a, you know, nice sound. Speaking of sound, like, auto-tune's been your big thing.
Yes.
So what made you go that route?
I've been using auto-tune since, like, I was 14. I used to do dance hall back then.
Okay.
Because Lawrence, where I'm from, is very big, dance hall.
Okay.
So, like, I used to just, I was like one of the first ones to do auto-tune on dance hall beats.
Yeah. Sounds like a nice combination.
And then, like, I don't know, so ever since then, like, I don't even use it, just, like, I use it because it makes my, like, it's like an effect. I use it, like, as, like, how people use compressors. Like, I don't use it just because, like, as singing and stuff. I use it as an effect.
Just like, you know, like a mix.
Yeah, like I use it like part of the compressors. Like, it's like a format I have. Like, I just put it. I don't even think about it anymore.
Word. That sounds good, man. I mean, especially with the way hip hop's going, melodic is kind of in, and you know, especially, I mean, we've seen the success of guys like Future. You know, obviously, there's a lot of guys that are kind of copying that sound, but you have a nice sound that, you know, kind of, I've known that sound to be yours. So yeah, you know, you rap, you also produce.
I'm a producer.
Yeah, you produce. Yeah, exactly. And that's one of the things that I think is dope. Dudes that, you know, rap or sing, whatever, and also produce. Man, just talk about kind of what's your inspirations for producing.
Producing is my main love. That's my everything. That's what, I've been making beats since I was like 12. That's what I love to do the most. I mean, I just started rapping on top of my beats not too long ago, like probably like 5 years ago.
So producing came first.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, word. That's cool, man. So speaking of, you know, music, you I heard a song a couple weeks back. You got a song, I can't think of the name, but it was Skippa Da Flippa. Pretty banger. For those that aren't familiar with Skippa Da Flippa, it's part of Quality Control, home to Migos. Richard Kidd, all those dudes out there. How'd you link up with him?
The dude that's on the song, his name's Christian Cartier. That's one of my boys right there. His management, Skipper's management. And we flew to Atlanta and we just went to Patchworks.
Yep.
Went there, we just stayed with chill with him for like hours. He's a cool dude. You know? Like, I actually thought he was gonna be like Hollywood, like we was there vibing and we came out with, like, that song was done, we did it, and we started switching shit around and then we threw Skippa on it because we played it for him and he liked that shit.
Word, so make sure you go to iTunes and grab that.
Comments.
For real, that's a banger. Elena, off camera we talked about you traveling, man. What's been some of your favorite places?
I like Atlanta, actually. Yeah. I've been to Atlanta, Miami. I've been to New York.
Six.
But I like Atlanta a lot because like downtown is like, shit looks crazy. It's not like New York downtown. Not like Times Square, but like, I don't know, Atlanta is crazy because like, 1 minute you could be downtown, crazy buildings, or like 2 minutes or like outside of it, you'd be like in the country. I don't know, I find it crazy.
Word, I gotta get down. That's like one of the few places I really want to go. And it's not too far. In 2016, you got the Wednesday project out. What's next, man? We gonna get the series going again? New project in the future or what?
Right now, I'm just focusing on the Wizz Wednesdays, releasing music for the Wednesday. Soon, I'm probably gonna make a real project. But right now, I'm just focusing on just banging out songs, creating a buzz.
Yeah, I mean, hopefully, you know, we get you some more exposure in the city for those that aren't familiar with the Wizz movement. But yeah, man, thank you.
Finally, thank you.
It was dope to meet, man. I've been banging your music for a while now, so it's always good to meet the artists and kind of hear a little bit about their story. But, you know, Grab Wednesday, SoundCloud, Lindsey Gamble, Wizz Dakota, HITP Music, Mass Apparel.
Hotels I be crashing, I ain't got no beef cause I'm all about the salad. Fuck around and I leave my chain hanging.